How you doing, my beloved PV Nation and my HBCU brethren and sister? This is Mike Prince from the Open Mic Broadcast Network. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Monday edition of the Mike Prince Show. Of course, we come to you weekdays at 10 a.m., somewhere around there for the most part, Central Standard Time, giving you the world of HBCU sports and beyond. We'll hear today about the Lincoln Blue Tigers resurgence and their victory over William Jewell. Rough weekend for the Blinn Buccaneers, but an exciting week of swag football play. And without any further delay, we'll jump right into today's episode. Man, what an exciting weekend of swag football. We'll talk about that a little bit later on. Congratulations to Mississippi Valley and Coach Vincent Dancy getting their first win in double overtime style. And another strong performance by the Southern Jaguars. Blinn Buccaneers had a rough homecoming this past weekend, losing to the Kilgore Rangers by the score of 28-21. We'll talk with Coach Mahon later on this week and try to see what the Bucs can do to recap and regroup, second consecutive loss in as many weeks. But now we'll hear from the Lincoln Blue Tiger report as they were victorious over William Jewell.
This is Dan Carr from Lincoln University of Missouri calling from Liberty, Missouri, where the Blue Tigers have defeated William Jewell 23-14. It was a masterful performance by Lincoln's defense as the Blue Tigers had more rushing yards in the game, 230, than the Cardinals had total yards, which was 222. It was also a big game for quarterback Henry Ogawa, who had a 158 yards passing with a touchdown, ran for another touchdown, and found Blake Tiz for 70 yards total during the game. Kimbo Ferguson, meanwhile, led the Lincoln ground attack with 112 yards as the Blue Tigers averaged 4.4 yards per carry for the contest. Defensively, Isaiah Gray had 5 tackles, including a tackle for loss, and Edwin Durascant had 3 quarterback hurries, while Juwan Chambers had 2. Again, the Blue Tigers defeated William Jewell 23-14 for their first true road win of the season.
And once again, congratulations to Coach Steve Smith and the Lincoln Blue Tigers. He's already got the Blue Tigers well ahead of schedule as far as win losses go. That now makes Lincoln Blue Tigers 2-1 in conference play. We made mention about the Blinn Buccaneers and their second loss consecutively this season, losing the prior week 71-28 to Cisco, then turned around at homecoming. Lost to Kilgore by the score of 28-21. We know this will drop the Buccaneers out of the top 10 of the polling of the National Junior College ranking, but they still have a lot of football left and can position themselves for some type of bowl invitation. They must continue on. They'll pick up next week against, I should say this week, New Mexico Military. Of course, you can listen to that game live right here on the Open Mic Broadcast Network. And if you want to check out any of the other Blinn rebroadcasts, simply go to the website obnradio.com and click on OBN Syndicated, or you can also go to Spreaker.com and look up Open Mic Broadcast Network. Now to the world of HBCU and SWAC in particular. As we may mention at the top of the show, Valley State gets their first win of the season with a double overtime victory against University of Arkansas Pine Bluff, winning by a score of 48-47. And you got to be excited for Coach Dancy and what he's trying to put together down in the Delta. We had the game of the week that featured Alcorn and Grambling. Grambling came in, fought hard, but fell short to Alcorn in what was yet another thriller. Grambling State now definitely on the outside looking in, and it'll truly be up to Southern now, who is in the driver's seat with their 21-7 victory over the Texas Southern Tigers this past weekend in Dallas at the Cotton Bowl. Southern University all of a sudden has resurged as the top team in the Western Division. Technically, Prairie View is in the number two spot because they had an idle week with Grambling's loss. Prairie View will have the tall order of hosting the Alcorn State Braves, who will come into town this coming weekend for homecoming 2018. Alcorn, by far, showing the most stable and consistent defense throughout the conference in the upper echelon when it comes to total yards, turnovers, and points scored against. So it'll be a tall order for the Ghost and staff to try and get some things worked up in the old PV lab. With this bye week, you would hope that there would be some type of fine-tuning and readjusting. I was a little bit concerned when I heard the soundbite from Coach Dooley when he said he didn't feel like that Southern had shut us down. I don't know what the definition of a shutdown is, but when you get shut out 38-0, it seems that it was a pretty good sound shutdown. However, with this bye week, we'll see if PV Nation can get back on track with things. My question, I have, I guess, some all-post bulletins. Seem like a couple of players have gone missing in action and not quite sure what has happened. Just putting out an all-post bulletin for where has Mr. Tristan Wallace been? Where has Brother Goodwater been? These two young men have been totally invisible. Looks like some strikes of brilliance early in the season. Not sure what's going on. Tristan Wallace, big-time transfer from the Dallas area, was a quarterback, converted over to wide receiver. Not sure if he's even on the radar for taking any reps at possibly being an emergency backup quarterback in the event we have a breakdown in that position in the very near future. Just interesting to see how PV defensive coordinator Coach Miller will address the run defense for PV Nation. A whole week to redefine and retool on some things, and hopefully they'll get that all sorted out. But Alcorn will be coming to town. Alcorn sitting on top in the East, but the A&M Bulldogs and the Jackson State Tigers are close behind. Jackson State will take on Southern University this weekend. And that becomes a game that PV Nation would hope that Southern would stumble against Jackson State. If that were be the case, and Grambling can finish strong at the Bayou Classic, there's still an outside chance for the Prairie View A&M University Panthers to represent the West. So come on, Jackson State, and do your thing. That's all we can do right now, being the situation that we're in as PV Nation. However, there is still a lot of football that remains. PV must take care of business against Alcorn and truly cannot afford to lose any more games this season. Still got a challenging game against Jackson State. Alabama State always plays PV tough. And then you have that rival game coming up against Texas Southern Tigers. That game, of course, will be on the hill, and it will be an interesting, intriguing factor to see how things go on. Now, what's at risk right now is that if we stumble out of the gate against Alcorn, what does that do for the remaining home game attendance? We know that there's been a challenge, not just at Prairie View, but just throughout HBCU athletics as a whole, about getting that casual fan engaged into being a part of the game day experience. And we know the hardcore fan is going to be there, rain, sleet, snow, or shine, but what is it that we can do that's going to attract that casual fan to want to come and be a part of that game day experience. A lot of it has to go with what have we done lately. It's a trendy type situation when you're talking about attendance in the HBCU realm. It's all about what have you done lately. Are you doing enough to even draw my attention to even look in that direction? So there are a lot of moving parts behind the scene, and we shall continue to keep a pulse on the situation. Speaking of a pulse on the situation, there was a basketball conference meeting on last week. We'll discuss a little bit of that later on this week. We'll hear, of course, from Coach Sandy Pugh and from Coach Byron Smith as they get ready to move forward in the 2018-19 edition of the Hardwood for PV Nation. Of course, Sandy Pugh being her first year coming from Southern, and she is ready to take this new look Lady Panthers and explode onto the scene. So we'll have those guys coming up throughout the course of this week and so much more to give you. Want to remind you that you can be a listening partner today by simply going to the website at obnradio.com, click on the PayPal button, and you can make your donation today for as little as 17 cents a day. That's only $5 a month, $60 for the entire year. Will help us to stay on the cutting edge to give you the latest and the greatest information, not only at Prairie View, but throughout the world of HBCU. Once again, visit that website at obnradio.com, click on the PayPal button, and become a listening partner today. Also want to share with you our 24-hour message line. You can call in and leave your questions, thoughts, comments, or concerns regarding PV Nation, HBCU Nation, or even our local high school coverage or the Blinn Buccaneers. That phone number is 713-570-6736. Well, it's Monday, and I think I've exhausted my time for today, and I must exit stage left. I am the radio guy, the Dr. Mike Prince. I want to thank you all so much for your continued support, your continued listening to the Open Mic Broadcast Network and all that we have to offer. Until the next time, you guys be blessed. We'll see you on the other side.